Arr, matey. This be the SS teacup. Enjoy this LP, or it's the plank with ye. That was my pirate voice. So, I have a confession. I played a little bit of this level already. I had a false start with the previous recording, and I had to redo it. But, I discovered something pretty cool during that initial recording. Let me see if I can get that to happen again. Remember those basket birds and how I wondered why they had a basket on their head if you couldn't ride in it? Well, I figured it out. I uncovered the secret. Alright, I just want to set you down. Is that cool? Okay, I'll come back for you. I discovered that... There we go. You can throw an enemy into the basket, and the bird will poop out 30 coins for you. Which is really cool. I discovered it totally by accident. It's a little tricky. Oh no! I killed it! Oh well. I got 10 coins out of it, at least. It's a little tricky to actually throw the enemies in there, but once you get the hang of it, it is an excellent source of coins. Aw. Don't disappear. Okay, thank you. 75 coins already. Those birds are an invaluable source of money in this game. Wonder if it respawns. Hey, it does. Neat. I could do this all day. I mean, I am a little worried about where those coins are coming from, but, you know, it's a dirty job, but someone has to do it. Okay, this was as far as I made it in this level before I had to restart the recording, so everything from this point on is blind. Hey, you. I don't like the cut of your sword. Hey. Oh, neat. Is there treasure up here? Come on, treasure. If I can get treasure and over 100 coins, then this will be quite a fruitful level. Aw, man. It'll be a lot harder to make this jump now. Dang it. I should have held on to my other hat. This is very mean of the game. Oh my god. To give you the wrong hat. I'm glad the thing didn't kill me. Dang it. I was caught between a spear and a chomp place. Alright, still haven't gotten a checkpoint, so I have to be a little careful. Aw, man? Where's the key? I bet the key's hidden in some of these blocks. And I can't get into them because I'm small Wario. Sad trombone. Okay, well, at least I know where the treasure is now. I hope the keys are in those blocks, because otherwise I don't know where it would be. Alright, maybe I can find another hat and come back here. I think I'm finally starting to figure this game out. You have to think outside the box a little bit if you want as many riches as you deserve. Okay, this bunny hat should make that part a lot easier, assuming I don't lose it. Because I can just glide right over these guys. And bypass that boulder entirely. Alright, come on, key. Here, key. Well, if it's in one of these, it's probably going to be in the last one. Okay, well, there's a doorway. Might be a key in there. Boy, this wallpaper is sure causing some havoc with the screen tearing there. Oh, hey. I raised the water level again. Wonder what that does. Oh, lets you get up here, it looks like. Extra life. There we go. Awesome. Whee! I hope that key doesn't disappear. Okay, good. Yeah, these last couple levels have gone much better than the first few have. Don't know what that is either. It's either some sort of... I guess it's a dagger. Even though it's shaped a little odd. Oddly. Okay, well. Jeez. I forgot how much fuel you actually get with this thing. You don't usually have that much space to fly. To be right on that door to go through it. I still haven't figured out what that thing is, that weird bug that flies away as you approach it. Jeez! Oh, I thought that thing was going to eat me. No! I thought there might be something down those pits, but that's probably not a good way to go. Screw you, Croc. Look at that. 123 coins. Very nice. Of course, if it weren't for those birds. I like how the more coins you have when you get to this area, the faster Wario is. Like if you hardly have any coins, he just kind of putters around, but if you have 123, he just zips. Alright, let's play this game. 20 coins out of 120 is pretty reasonable. Alright, I got 4 on this last time I tried. Let's see if I can get 5. Now that I have a better sense for how these enemies move and how much power you need to hit them. These things really remind me of an enemy from the webcomic Kid Rad. They remind me of the bogeys. It's a really cool webcomic. It's about a fictional 8-bit video game called Kid Rad. And it ended a few years ago, but the archives are still online. It's Kid R-A-D-D. I recommend it. Alright, well, I spent 20 coins and got an extra life. I think that was a pretty good deal. And I have 4 treasures now. Things are finally starting to go my way. Man, I'm not even on the SST cup yet. That thing looked almost like a sniffit. Like a scuba sniffit. Oh, I guess not. I guess it was just when its mouth was open. It kind of had that round, sniffit-like appearance. I thought maybe I could, go back and forth between these walls and, bounce my way up, but once you hit a wall, you can't activate the jetpack again. Oh yeah, that's right, I remember I can hit these things from below and safely take care of them. So let's go ahead and do that. No way to actually hit that block though. Maybe if I had the dragon hat, I could probably hit it from here, but no way to get it in my current state. Ah, what? That is. I guess I should have anticipated that that was actually a spear gun, and not just a spear or a harpoon gun. I think the only difference between a spear and a harpoon is that a harpoon is used around water. Other than that. Alright, so now that I... Never mind. I was gonna say, now that I know I can hit those things from the bottom, I can get down there, but I already did that. Alright, with these harpoon guys, I can pretty much hit them anywhere as long as I don't hit them in the harpoon, it looks like. I can just kind of bump into them. Very weird that there are enemies you can kill just by bumping into them. I don't think I've ever played a platformer with those kind of enemy physics. Well, I can get this and then go back and get whatever's in that other box. I mean, it might be nothing, or it might be a key. You never know. Oh, I didn't even get that box this time. Okay, just more hearts. But hey, the more the merrier. I do like the swimming physics more than a traditional Mario game. I like being able to just hold the button down. I think I'll hold on to my dragon. Seems to be much more useful underwater than the bull helmet. Man, I want some more of those birds. Those things were awesome. Of course, there are no enemies that I could actually throw into the basket. In this area, anyway. I could throw those guys into a bird basket. But I guess that's not an enemy. It gives you... You know, it doesn't just give those bird baskets out willy-nilly. Oh, that's right. Someone did mention that with the bull helmet, you can jump into the ceiling and stick into it with your horns. But I don't have the bull helmet, so I can't do that. Maybe... I wonder if the other bull helmet is still there. I know it's a lot of backtracking, but I'm really, really curious about what's over to the left there. And I want to show off the, show off the ceiling hanging ability. I don't know. I was going to say it probably disappeared, but I think power-ups don't disappear when you leave the screen. That's very, very nice of the game to leave it there for me. Once I decide I want it again. Or once I change my mind and decide I want it. I don't remember how you actually stick to things, though. I think you just hit up. Yep, there we go. Okay. I forgot about that until I saw that conveyor belt. I kind of wish it had something like this conveyor belt sooner, earlier in the game. So I would have been able to figure this out sooner. Come on, treasure. Whee! I'm gonna be doing that all the time now. That was 100 coins. That was well worth going back for the bull helmet. Now, do I want to switch back to the dragon helmet? I guess so. I guess my use for the bull helmet is, oh, there's a checkpoint here too. Sweet. My, use for the bull helmet is at an end. Unless I go through this door and there's another conveyor belt on the ceiling. But it doesn't look like it. Okay, so I actually hit that thing before it flew off the screen, but it didn't seem to do anything. I don't know. I don't know what the deal with these bugs is. Okay, so I'm going to have to hit it with my dragon hat from the other side. There's probably, yep, another invisible block there. Music is a little repetitive. It's just kind of the same couple sounds over and over again. Oh, I see what I have to do. Very clever game. Hey! That's nice of it. Wee-hee! Dang it, Wario. There you go. Good job. Alright. 133 coins. The coin production in this game is definitely starting to pick up. Alright, let's see if I can get me another one up. Now that I know what to do in this game, I like it a lot more than the coin doubling game. I mean, it would be nice if I could double my coins when I have that many, but, you know, a 50-50 shot is just not good enough odds. If there was some way for me to boost my odds, then I would be more open to the other game. But as it is, I'm happy enough just spending 20 coins to come in here and get a 1-up. We're not getting a 1-up, you know, either way. I knew as soon as I said, get a 1-up, I was going to miss one. Oh well, 70 hearts is still pretty good. That's practically a 1-up. And 113 coins into the stash. Into the hoard. Alright, well, this has been SST Cup. That'll about do it for this episode. Tune in tomorrow when I hopefully actually get onto the ship. See you soon.